Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another vlog of Adash Automotives. So here we are with the all new Tata Punch, and all thanks to Manikbok Automobiles for letting us review the vehicle. I'm so stressed out. Everything just feels like a test that I feel so depressed when I can't seem to get out. But something deep inside won't let me quit. I swear that I'm inspired by all this shit. Tell me that I can't and I won't. That's what guides me the most. Fuck your lies, I'll do what I want. I guess I'm so for the ones who are confused, so this is the Tata Punch that sits exactly between the Tata Tiago and the mid-size SUV, the Tata Nexon. And starting from the hood is pretty light and it gets insulation, so that's a great thing. And this is the 3-cylinder unit that is upgoing right now in the current market, so it's pretty refined that it'll get to here in a while. So let's close this for a while. Now it gets the same front treatment as that of the Harrier. The DRLs are upright up top and the headlights are on the bumper with the projector setup and the high beam with the halogen. And it gets the humanity line running all over the front grille with tri-arrow treatment for the horn to pop out. And also it gets the air linings at the bottom of the bumper, that is with the tri-arrow treatment all over it. So moving towards the side, it gets 16-inch diamond cut alloys which really flushes well with the side cladding or the wheel cladding, and the cladding runs over all of the side. So it could have been better if Tata would have offered bigger sized wheels so that it could fill the cladding properly all over it. And it also gets request sensor on the driver's side. The rear door looks clean and the handle is offered at the top near the window. So it's a bit dirty right now as we have got it off the road, as you can see it right now. And also in the later part you will see it on our traditional off-road track, so stay tuned for it. And the rear end also gets these taillights finished in tri-arrows, and the lower side of the bumper is finished in black, looks a bit overridden. And it gets the reverse parking camera here. And now opening the trunk, so it gets a 366 liters of trunk, so this is where the Punch really excels. But the loading lip is a point high, and you also get a Rhino, just click it over here, and also a rear mono wipo. And that's it for the exteriors, there is nothing much to tell about. And it also gets contrast colors over the roof and also over the mirrors. You can also get a black, any customized color, whatever you wish for. So moving inside the rear seats, so the front driver seat is set to my height. So as you can see right now, there's adequate space. There's around 2 inches of space for my knee room. But you see that the head is almost rubbing over the roof. So rear seats might not be as comfortable for tall passengers. I am 5'11", so you can see that it's pretty flushed in out here. And the middle transmission tunnel is almost flat, so you can fit in 3, but could not be as comfortable because it's a small sized SUV. It also misses out on rear AC vents, but the front ACs are strong enough that you will feel the chills at the back also. And the rears are equipped with 4 speakers and the front gets 6 speakers, so that is a combination of 10 speakers which is all tuned by Harman. And you also get this for center armrest for the rear passengers and adjustable headrest for 2, so the middle passenger doesn't get any headrest. So that's a cliche out there. And now that's enough of the rear seats, let's jump into the front seats and see what it has got to offer. So here's a request sensor for the driver side but not for the passenger. And the USP of Altroz has been carried over to the Tata Punch, so it gets 90 degree opening doors which is really comfortable to get in and out. So getting in, he gets the engine start stop button, so that's a nice touch. So let me turn on the car now. So clutch is in, it shows the Tata logo and does a full swipe. So it gets the same instrument cluster as that of the Harrier and the Altroz. So, but it's finished out in squared out edges, which looks a bit out of place, but nevertheless it's a good thing. And it also shows the alignment of the wheels. The tachometer and the speedometer is in the analog, and you get this steering mounted buttons. So these are for the audio system and these are for the instrument cluster. So the instrument cluster is pretty much loaded. It also gets a cruise control and it gets distance to empty and instant fuel economy and that regular stuff that you get in the Altroz as well as on the Harrier. Now the center console, it's a 7-inch one, so it is compiled with 10 speakers that are from Harman, and the audio quality is also really good. So now let's listen to the audio quality. So the audio from these 10 speakers is just fabulous. So Tata has really done a good work with the infotainment system. And talking about the dashboard is also really finished well with these plastics. All of them are hard plastics but are really of good quality. You can see the blacked out finish and this brushed out finish in the middle, and also the white finish. If you look closely, you can see this is also finished in the tri-aero treatment, and the lower down plastics are a bit of poor quality. And when it comes to space, you can see that the front glove box is really spacious, and also the door pockets are large enough to hold 1 liter bottle as well as some other stuff. So the one we are driving is a manual one. It also comes in a automatic, that is a 5-speed automatic or a 5-speed manual, and it also has automatic climate control. So now that's enough of the interiors and the exteriors, and let's get driving. Please consider subscribing to the channel and help us reach the 1k mark as soon as possible. So that's the least you can do to watch our exclusive content. So here we are behind the wheel, and the air conditioner is turned off, eco mode is disabled, left foot on the clutch and right foot on the accelerator, revs up almost up to 500 rpm. Okay, so there's a bit of wheel spin but not punchy or anything. So this is a 3-cylinder 1.2 liter engine which produces 86 horsepower and 130 newton meters of torque. Actually, the performance from the motor is not punchy or anything, but pretty flat. You can well define it as adequate, but not punchy. And talking about the engine refinement levels, the engine is really refined and there are no vibrations as such as you could expect from a 3-cylinder engine. It is pretty well refined. Only you can hear is a bit of whine from the motor. So we have got it on the countryside roads, and as you can see it is pretty maneuverable here, and also the steering wheel is light enough to maneuver it around in the tight spaces, and surely it is a head turner as this is a new car and the design is also fresh. And talking about the comfort levels, so the Tata has equipped it with the suspensions that are pretty similar to that of the Harrier, and the comfort levels are absolutely brisk on this one as it gets a softer adjustment, and the rear passengers as well as the front co-passenger and the driver are pretty comfortable on it. And also the body roll is very well contained, and as the steering feedback is just on point. And considering the competition, that is the Magnite or the Kiger and also the Suzuki Ignis, they are bigger in size as compared to this one, but it surely excels when it comes to comfort and handling capabilities, the straight line cruising. The Tata Punch takes it all away from them, and the braking performance is also short footed, but as it's a new car, the bite from the brakes is not good, but it can surely excel in the long run. And speaking about the fuel economy, now it's showing as 8 kilometers per liter as of now, as we are riding it onto these country roads and pretty fast. So you can expect it to return around 15 kilometers per liter to 20 kilometers per liter in the real world. So now let's talk about the real point, that is the off-road capabilities of this car. But considering that it is a front wheel car, we are not gonna get it into any harsh conditions, and as hype from Tata that it can take up on really hard trails. And talking on the safety front, it gets two airbags, EBS, EBD, ESC, and cornering brake control, and also a brake sway control, as Tata likes it to call, that is the cornering rollover mitigation function. So it is pretty loaded, and also get Tata assurance that you might see in the global NCAP test also. So we are here at the off-road track, and it's a pretty steep climb. So let's see how the Tata Punch performs. So that was a pretty steep angle, but it managed pretty well, and the approach angle and the downside angle that it drops down is really well on the Tata Punch. And as you can see, this is also a pretty steep climb, but it climbs up really well. And also there's an automatic version, that's a 5-speed automatic or a 5-speed manual that you get. So in a 5-speed automatic, you have an option that you can lock one of the tire, that's just the front tires, either the right or the left. You can lock one of the tires and 100% of torque or the power is delivered to one tire. That is, you have to catch the brake and just throttle out. So the system does its work and locks one of the wheels and gets you out of the dirt. And this ground clearance of 186mm of the Tata Punch really helped it climb the steep very well. And we're almost up the mountain hill. So that's it for the off-road, and let's get this back down. Something deep inside won't let me quit. I swear that I'm inspired by all this shit. Tell me that I can and I won't. That's what guides me the most. Fuck your lies, I'll do what I want. As you saw, it managed the off-road pretty well. Actually it really managed it well, but considering the it is only the front wheel drive, so don't take it off to very harsh off-roads or to any steep climbs, because you might get stuck or anything. But considering the front wheel drive, it's a really capable off-roader. And our verdict on this one is that it is a pretty compact SUV, and for daily usage or city usage, this is a really good vehicle. And considering its competitors, it has its own taste. It is very flexible, and the only thing that it misses out is on a engine options. That is, you don't get a diesel or even a turbo petrol. But the turbo petrol is, for as of now, it is not there. But depending upon the customer feedback, the Tata is going to take a decision saying that it might get a turbo petrol in the near future. Hello. So that's it for today's video. I'll see you in the next vlog.